farmers' movement has been really historic and unprecedented, not only so far as India is concerned, but probably also in the world in recent times. What I feel is that there are certain very important characteristics which really make it unique. Number one, 500 and more Kisan organizations came together, formed the Sayukta Kisan Morcha, and have been leading this struggle unitedly for more than a year. I think this is an unprecedented thing in the India that we know, because there have been united struggles, etc. But such a huge struggle, you know, and 500 organizations coming together, that is number one. Secondly, the important thing is the central trade unions, all the industrial federations, etc. Right from day one, they have been supporting this farmer struggle totally. So that whole worker-peasant unity concept that has actually been come into action. In fact, as you know, the struggle itself began with a united worker-peasant action. 26th of November, farmers marched to Delhi, braving all the other repression and all that. But the same day was the All India strike by the working class of India. Same day, 26th of November. And therefore, they all came together. The struggle started unitedly. This agitation has combated repression like very few agitations have done in recent years. As I said, you know, the whole, the way the thing began on the 26th November, the kind of tear gas shells, the water cannons, the arrests, all these things that happened. And then finally, of course, the Lakhimpur Khiri incident, where straight four farmers were just mowed down by the cars of the Union Minister of State for Home. I think such a thing has never happened. But it has, in spite of all the repression, not only here, Haryana, UP, so many places. I mean, there are so many examples, there's no time to dwell on that. But they have stood their ground in spite of that.
This is, without doubt in my mind, the largest peaceful democratic protest that has occurred in the world in several years, and easily the greatest that has been organized and taken place in the midst of an unprecedented pandemic. Not even, and let's say in the pre-pandemic period, not even the Occupy Wall Street movement achieved this momentum, and it certainly did not achieve its success in a come down by a government. Yeah, it was physically finally dispersed. So I'm saying that you find me the movements, democratic movements or protest movements in the last several years in this world that have shown the resilience, willpower and democratic behavior that this movement has. That makes it unique. The second thing is that within the country, in my lifetime, I have not seen such a movement. Yeah? With that kind of resonance everywhere.
Collective leadership jo hai, wo emerge kari. Wo unique hai humare jaise Guru Gobind Singh ne matlab yahi ek sandesh diya tha ki jab aap ikatthe ho ke faisla karenge tab aap theek faisle pe pahunchenge. To iski jo bahut unique hai jo baki movement mein kahin aapko individualization jo hai, individual leader को बिल्ट किया जाता है. ब्रिटिश ने भी किया कि इंडिविजुअल लीडर को बिल्ट करो और बाद में फिर उससे मतलब आप कब मैनेज कर सकते हैं. तो इसमें एक तो कलेक्टिव थी, दूसरा जो था कि जो महिलाओं का हिस्सा है वो एक बहुत ही खूबसूरत हुआ, क्योंकि हमारे हरियाणा में महिला सारी खेती करती थी लेकिन वो कहीं विजिबल नहीं थी. लेकिन मैं जब कई दफ़ा गया तो मतलब उन्होंने यहाँ तक भी कह दिया कि आप ये जो धरना लगाने का काम है ये तो हम कर लेंगे, आप कहीं और काम करो. तो वो इसका दूसरा यूनिक. तीसरा ये है कि इसने एक बहुत ही मंथन करवाया कि वो लगातार एक सोचने की प्रक्रिया जो है वो पैदा की, जिससे जो रियलिटी है उसका वो कारण समझने में उनको समय लगी. पहले कॉरपोरेट से शुरू हुआ, अब महिलाओं को ये भी पता लग गया कि डीमोनेटाइजेशन उनकी सेविंग छीनने का काम था, क्योंकि उन्होंने रियली, लेकिन वो कब तक उसको कोरलेट. तो इसलिए इस मूवमेंट ने बहुत बड़ा एक कल्चरल, मैं उसे फ्लड कहता हूँ, और जैसे उसने कल्चरल चेंज भी की कि जिन नौजवानों को हम नॉन सीरियस समझ रहे थे उन्होंने जिम्मेवारी ली, मतलब घरों में हम जिनके जो शहीद हुए हैं उन परिवारों में गए तो वहाँ उत्साह है, वो निराशा नहीं है कि अगर पिता मर गया तो बच्चा कहता मैं भी ये काम करूँगा, तो ये एक नई स्पिरिट और रियलिटी को लाने वाली है।
The land surveys that have been conducted by the government a very few years ago have come to the conclusion that 86% of the farmers in India are either marginal or small farmers. A marginal farmer is defined as one with less than 1 acre, 1 hectare of land. A small farmer is defined as one with less than 2 hectares of land. As we know, 1 hectare means 2.5 acres. So therefore, less than 5 acres, you have 86% of the farming population. Secondly, many surveys have been done of the actual people who are there in the Delhi borders. Another survey has been done of these 700 odd farmers who have died in this agitation as martyrs. Both these surveys have shown very clearly that a very large majority, both of the farmers who died and the farmers who are actually taking part in the struggle right here at the Delhi borders, more than 80% of them are from the marginal and the small farmers category. Some have a little bit more, that is middle farmers, but there are very few among the rich farmers who are actually sitting on the roads. The same situation is there all over India where they are actually taking part, so that also holds true for that.
Thank you. One of the very interesting and unnoticed things that happened, you know, while the media vilify this movement as Punjabis and Haryanvis and rich farmers, one of the things that many people did not notice was that the elections, when the elections to Tamil Nadu, Bengal, Kerala took place, it surprised me that only one polling agency, the APT Research Agency in Tamil Nadu, actually asked a question about the farmers' agitation. It offended me that the others did not do it, because you took it for granted that it's all Punjab and Haryana. They asked people of Tamil Nadu, not just farmers, they asked the people of Tamil Nadu the question, what is your attitude to the farmers sitting at the gates of Delhi? 82% of respondents declared total solidarity. My take, if you'd asked that question in Kerala, you'd have got 100%. In Andhra, you'd have got 90%, 95%. In Karnataka, you'd have got 90-95% as well. It shows that this movement, one, inspired farmers and non-farmers alike and captured the imagination of people, you know, people standing up against a behemoth, taking a beating, 700 people dying in the process, but unflinching and resolute.
बहुत narrative बनाए गए, लेकिन जो असलियत है कि गांव का मजदूर भी, किसान भी, सभी आए, हर तरह की महिला भी आई, और परिवारों के परिवार यहाँ हैं। एक तो है कि वो, और अगर कितने अमीर लोग हैं, अगर अमीर होते तो वो होटल में ठहरते, वो वहाँ मतलब सड़क के किनारे पे तो मतलब एक साल नहीं गुजारते। तो पहले तो है कि ये नरेशन बनाने की कोशिश की गई अभी भी लोगों को कि इसमें मतलब आतंकवादी आ गए हैं, मतलब जबकि वो खुद आतंकवाद कर रहे हैं, लेकिन उनको कहेंगे। लेकिन इस सारी चीज़ को मतलब इस पूरी मूवमेंट ने बिल्कुल निरखास्त किया, इसको मतलब बिल्कुल बता दिया कि ये चीज़ें नहीं हैं। लोग सीरियसली, और वो सीरियसली क्राइसिस को डील कर रहे हैं। गांव का, मैं कहता हूँ, एग्रेरियन क्राइसिस है ये, सिर्फ किसान की बात नहीं है। गांव में ये लोगों को समझ लग गई कि ये, क्योंकि 60% लोग गांव में खेती पे निर्भर हैं, लेकिन उसके साथ ही वो पूरा हिस्सेदारी हुई। और आप अगर मतलब वहाँ देखें तो वो 1 लाख अमीर आदमी नहीं हैं।
You saw the Vidhan Sabha elections, assembly elections a few months ago. The SKM had given a call that defeat BJP. Whoever you elect is your business, but defeat the BJP. Three out of four states, the people defeated the BJP. I'm not saying that the SKM should get all the credit. It is the people over there, it is the forces over there who also made a very big attempt. Kerala, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, the BJP was roundly defeated. It was defeated also in the local body elections in Uttar Pradesh, panchayat elections and the municipal elections in Punjab. Just this year, little bit earlier this year, and now in the by-elections in Himachal Pradesh, Haryana, Rajasthan. So therefore, it was very clear that this is now creating a political impact. And that is what frightened the powers that be. The last point, the last important point is this, that this is the agitation which has squarely attacked the whole nexus of corporate communalism, represented by the Modi, Shah, BJP, RSS government on the one hand, and its closest ally in India, the corporate lobby led by the Ambanis, Adanis, and the other domestic and foreign corporates on the other. So this has taken them on directly. You see, there has been a lot of talk about all this. And in that sense, it has attacked the pro-corporate policies of this government. And it has also attacked, in a way, all the demands, if you see, repeal the farm laws, MSP, electricity bill withdrawal. Actually, these are all demands which are directed against the neoliberal policies of the government.
Your media, when they told you nothing about the election, by-elections to 29 state assembly seats and 3 parliamentary seats, Lok Sabha seats. If you look at the results of those elections, as I think Mr. Modi and Shah did, they understood. Mr. Modi understood much better the signal of those elections than the media had the gumption or the courage to state. You look at the Times of India's editorials, Indian Express editorials. Elections are often won by ruling parties, etc., etc., conspicuously avoiding a mention of two factors. One, the Kisan Andolan, the farmers' agitation. Two, COVID mismanagement, which was appalling in UP and which people feel very strongly about, which returning migrants are really upset about. And the COVID mismanagement and these were not a factor in the analysis of the big press and the big media. However, you look at it, those states where the Kisan Andolan was vigorous, states like Rajasthan, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, there the results were extremely adverse for the BJP. The ruling party in Himachal is the BJP itself. If the analysis of the media were correct, it should have swept those seats. But even though the Supreme Court stayed the implementation of the laws, their impact was already seen at the mandis when the Adani groups, the Business Standard reported that the Adani groups' offer of prices for the prime variety of apple was some 18% below the previous year's price, which was a pandemic year, a distress price, right? And of course, the farmers resisted vigorously and it was sorted out. But it meant you were starting at such a low price offer. So they were wiped out in Himachal, where they are the ruling party. Then in Rajasthan, you've been in journalism for 40 odd years. You know that no Sangh Parivar formation, whether Jana Sangh or the Janata Party faction of Janata Morarji, nor the BJP. When did you last see them come third and fourth in constituencies in Rajasthan? In Haryana, Abhay Chautala stepped down, resigned on the ground of moral grounds of farmers' agitation. The opposition should have united behind him because all of them claimed to be for, instead of which, the Congress party put up a candidate who lost his deposit, a senior candidate. He lost his deposit, but, kept the, he took 20,000-25,000 votes away from Abhay Chautala. From the CM to the DM, as people who were involved in the campaign tells me, everybody was out campaigning for the BJP candidate. The entire cabinet of Haryana and many from Delhi Union cabinet were there to support him. Still, Chautala won by over 6,000 votes. I think, my belief is that they understood the signals, that the farmers' agitation is very vigorous, it's going to affect this, and they are really bothered only about two things. One is the UP election. They know that they are annihilated in Punjab, whatever they say, and the 2024, which their own leaders like Satpal Malik were telling them, we'll get wiped out. If this continues till 2024, we are going to be in really big trouble.
मैं ये कहता हूँ, वो तपस्या जानते हैं कि आपने राम नाम की माला फेरनी है, और राम नाम की माला जो है वो OECD ने जो इनको एजेंडा दिया 2018 में कि आप मतलब खाने वाली चीज़ें एक्सपोर्ट करके पैसा कमा सकते हैं, वो मेरा ख्याल उसकी माला फेरते रहे। वो जो तपस्या कह रहे हैं, तपस्या तो इन लोगों ने की है जो हर मुसीबत में मोर्चे पर डटे रहे और हर तरह की। और दूसरा, मैं समझता हूँ कि जितना कोविड का था, हम जब आते थे तो यहाँ कोविड ख़त्म हो जाता था तो मतलब उसमें भी मतलब जो चीज़ उन्होंने प्रूव की कि अगर आप अच्छा खुराक खाने वाला खाएंगे तो बीमारी से बचे रहें। तो ये नरेशंस जो हैं वो बिल्ट किए उन्होंने, और वो अपने आप को मास्टर समझते हैं। अब भी वो यही धोखा खड़ा कर रहे हैं, लेकिन किसान और लोग उसको मानने वाले नहीं हैं। वो उनको अब चेतनता आ गई है।